Animal tissues. Topics to be covered in this chapter are Introduction, Types of Animal Tissues. In this topic, we are going to study different types of animal tissues, that is epithelial tissue, muscular tissue, connective tissue, nervous tissue, and last, summary. Let's start from the introduction of this topic. We are going to study types of animal tissues. But before that, you should know how cells are multiplies or divides. You all know that plants and animals both are made up of cells. Any multicellular organism starts its life with a single cell. Then cell multiplies, multicellular organism get composed. But plants and animals have different structures and hence they have different types of cells, tissue, organs. We have already discussed in our previous topic that many cells which perform the same function when comes together, they form a tissue. Tissue play an important role in structural organization of animals. So, let's see the definition of tissue. A group of cells with a similar structure and working together for a specific function called as a tissue. Types of animal tissues. Basically, there are four types of animal tissues: epithelial tissue, muscular tissue, connective tissue, and nervous tissue. Epithelial tissue is covering and protective tissue. So, on the basis of shapes and number of layers, they are of four types: squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium, columnar epithelium, and glandular epithelium. Then muscular tissue. Muscular tissue provides posture, body support, structure, mechanism of contraction, relaxation, and attachments. So, on the basis of function of muscular tissue, they are of three types. That is skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle. Then connective tissue. Connective tissue provides transport system within our body for oxygen and other important substances. Connective tissue provides binding and support to our body. Again, on the basis of different types of functions, connective tissue also divided into five types: areolar, supporting, adipose, skeletal, and fluid. Then supporting connective tissue also divided into two types, tendon and ligament. Again, skeletal connective tissue divided into two types, cartilage and bone. And last, fluid connective tissue. The example of fluid connective tissue is blood. Nervous tissue. Nervous tissues are highly specialized for being stimulated and then transmitting the messages rapidly from one place to another place within the body. So, this is all about the types of animal tissues. Epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is the covering or protective tissue in the animal body. Then, what is the main role of this tissue? The main role of this tissue is, it covers most of the organs which are present within a body. You can see here different types of organs: stomach, kidney, liver, lungs. These are all the types of organs which are present inside the body. And epithelial tissue covers these organs and also form a barrier to keep different body systems separated. You can see here many types of systems such as excretory system, digestive system. So, the main function of epithelial tissue is to cover or protects the body organs and forms a barrier to keep different body systems separate. For example, the lining of mouth, blood vessels, kidney tubules, which are made up of epithelial tissues. Now, let's see some basic characteristics of epithelial tissues. First characteristic is structure of a cell. Cells of epithelial tissue are tightly packed and forms a continuous sheet. Because of that, very small intracellular spaces are present, or we can say intracellular spaces are absent between them. And because of this, they have very little cementing material between them. So obviously, anything entering or leaving the body must cross at least one layer of epithelium. And because of this structure, epithelial tissue play an important role in regulating the exchange of materials between the body and external environment. These cells of epithelial tissue has the high power of regeneration. Then basement membrane. On the basis of layers, shape and their function, epithelial tissues are of two types. Which are these? That is simple and stratified. But before we discuss the types of epithelial tissue, we should know that cells of epithelial tissues are based or rest upon basement membrane, or we can say basement matrix. What is this basement membrane? This basement membrane is made up of two layers, that is outer basal lamina and reticular lamina. Epithelial tissue is avascular, means it does not have any kind of own blood supply. Then how it will get nourishment? As we have already discussed, that epithelial tissue is covering or protective tissue. So the cells of this tissue get nourishment from the underlying tissue, which has the blood supply. So a nutritive substance which has blood supply and nutritive substance by diffusion method provide a nourishment to this tissue. Epithelial tissue serves as a semi-permeable membrane. So, on the basis of layer and shapes, epithelial tissues divided into two types, that is simple and stratified. If cells are present only in one layer, that is called as simple epithelial tissue. And if cells are present in many layers, that is called as stratified epithelial tissues. There are three types of simple epithelial tissue, that is squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and columnar epithelium. So let's see these epithelial tissues one by one. First, squamous epithelium. The squamous epithelium is made up of a single layer of flattened cell. You can see here the squamous epithelium, which is made up of single layer of flattened cell. They are found in esophagus, walls of blood vessels, air sacs of lungs and lining of mouth. Different epithelia show different structures that correlate with their unique functions. The squamous epithelium is made up of single layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. You can see here the single layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. Then simple cuboidal epithelium. You can see here the structure of cells, which are cube shape. Cuboidal means cube-like structure. Simple cuboidal epithelium consists of a single layer of cuboidal cells. Then these cuboidal cells have large spherical and central nuclei. This is nuclei which is present at the center of these cells. Simple cuboidal epithelium are found on the surface of ovaries, the line of nephrons, the walls of the renal tubules and parts of eye and thyroid. Simple columnar epithelium. So, simple columnar epithelium is again the type of columnar epithelium which is composed of a single layer of tall pillar-like cells. You can see here the cells of these tissues are tall pillar-like structure. In the cells of columnar epithelial tissue, again nuclei is present but at the base. You can see here the nuclei which are present at the base. These are nuclei. So these three tissues are simple epithelial tissues, that is squamous, cuboidal and columnar. Why these are called as simple epithelial tissues? Because these tissues are only in one layer. Then stratified epithelial tissue. First one is stratified squamous epithelium. Cells of this tissue present in multiple layers. These cells are also flattened in structure, and stratified squamous epithelium consists of flattened epithelial cells arranged in many layers, and that's why this is called as stratified squamous epithelium. Only one layer is attached to the basement membrane and other layers are adhered to one another for structural integrity. Our skin is also made up of epithelial tissues. Skin epithelial cells arranged in pattern of layers. These epithelial is called stratified squamous epithelium because they have more than one layer. Then stratified cuboidal epithelium. Stratified cuboidal epithelium is a type of epithelial tissue which is composed of multiple layers of cube-shaped, cube-like structures, multiple layers of cube-like structures. Epithelial cells often acquire additional specialization and these epithelial tissues folds inwards. You can see here in this image, these epithelial tissues folds inwards and form multicellular gland. This is glandular epithelium which secretes the substances which we can call as hormones. What is this glandular epithelium? So let's see the function of this glandular epithelium. A gland is one or more cells that produce and secrete a specific product. The product is always a water-based fluid and usually contains proteins. So the product which secretes from glands, that process is called as secretion. Then secretion is considered as an active process. Glandular cells obtain substances needed from blood and transport them chemically into product, that's discharge from the cell. Secretion is considered as an active process. So glandular cells obtain substances needed from blood and transform them chemically into a product which discharge from the cell. It means glandular epithelium secretes hormones inside the body as well as outside the body. So the example of inner side secretion is saliva and the outside secretion is sweat. So glandular epithelium secretes hormones inside the body as well as outside the body. Then pseudostratified columnar epithelium. If you observe these cells under an electron microscope, these cells, it looks like these cells present in more than one layers. But these cells are the type of simple epithelium, means they have only one layer and all these cells are rest on basal lamina. And because of the structure of these cells, the cell is called as pseudostratified. Pseudostratified columnar epithelium are ciliated. So, if cilia is present, then it is called as pseudostratified ciliated columnar epithelium. So, what is the function of this cilia? Ciliated tissues are commonly found in respiratory tract, uterus, fallopian tubes, etc. So, the major function of this tissue is to move mucus and other substances via cilia. So, this is all about types of epithelial tissue. Muscular tissue. So, student, muscular tissue provides posture, body support, structure, mechanism of contraction, relaxation, and attachments. So, on the basis of function of muscular tissue, they are of three types. That is skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle. So, let's discuss these different types of muscular tissues one by one. Before we going to discuss the skeletal muscle, please see this vehicle. We can start when we want to start and stops when we decide. Like this vehicle, Muscles which are present in our limbs move when we want to move and stop when we decide. Such muscles are called as voluntary muscles. These muscles are called striated or skeletal muscle. Why it is called as striated muscles? When we observe these muscles under a microscope, we can see these muscles showing alternate light and dark bands, and hence they are called as striated muscles. The cells of these muscles are usually long, cylindrical, unbranched and multinucleated, means they have many nuclei. These muscles are attached to our bone. Our bone movement occurs because of these muscles. The skeletal muscle controlled by nervous muscle, then smooth muscle. The movement of food in alimentary canal or the contraction and relaxation of blood vessels are involuntary movements, means we cannot really start them or stop them when we want. Smooth muscles or involuntary muscles control such type of movements. They are also found in arteries of eye, in the uterus and in the bronchi of lungs. The cells of these tissues are long with pointed ends, means they are spindle shape in structure and uninucleate. Uninucleate again, cells of this tissue having single nucleus in them. They are also called as unstriated or non-striated muscles as they do not show light and dark bands under a microscope. Then cardiac muscles. The muscles of the heart show rhythmic contraction and relaxation. Everybody can observe the contraction and relaxation of their heart. So, the muscle of the heart show rhythmic contraction and relaxation throughout the life. These muscles are called cardiac muscles, which is also called as involuntary muscles because we cannot start or stop them when we want. The cells of cardiac muscles are cylindrical, branch and uninucleate. Connective tissue. Now tell me, why would it be called as connective tissue? The reason is, this tissue supports, connects or separates different types of tissues and organs in the body. The cells of these tissues are loosely packed and have intracellular spaces between them. These cells are embedded in an intracellular matrix. These intracellular matrix are maybe jelly-like, fluid, dense, so there are different types of connective tissue. Blood is one of the type of connective tissue. Why blood is called as connective tissue? Because blood connects the body systems together, bringing the needed oxygen, nutrients, and hormones and removing the waste. Hence, it is called as connective tissue. Then, another type of connective tissue is bone. What is the function of bones? Bones supports the body, rather connects the body and also anchors the muscles and supports main organ of the body. It is strong and non-flexible tissue. Bone cells are embedded in a hard matrix that is composed of calcium and phosphorus compounds. You can see here bone cells which are embedded in a hard matrix which are composed of calcium and phosphorus compounds. Then ligament. Ligament is one of the type of connective tissue where two bones, you can see here in the image, ligament is the another type of connective tissue in which two bones can be connected to each other. This tissue has considerable strength with great elasticity. Tendon. Tendons connect the muscles to bones and are another type of connective tissue. You can see here these tendons which connect the muscles to the bones. Tendons are fibrous tissue with great strength but limited flexibility. It is not as flexible as ligaments. Then cartilage. Cartilage tissue has widely spaced cells. The solid matrix of cartilage cells are composed of proteins and sugars. Then the function of cartilage is it smoothens the bone surfaces at joints and is also present in nose, ear, trachea and larynx. We can fold cartilage of the ear but cannot fold bones present in the arms. Then areolar. Areolar connective tissue is found between the skin and muscles, around blood vessels, nerves and in bone marrow. So this tissue fills the space which is present inside the organ. It supports internal organs and helps in repairing of tissues. Adipose tissue. Now tell me, where is the fat stored in our body? The answer is in adipose tissue, which is also one of the type of connective tissue. You can see here in the image, the yellow colored bubble like structure is adipose tissue. Adipose tissue is fat storing tissues which is found below the skin and between the internal organs. The cells of these tissues are filled with fat globules. This yellow colored portion is fat globules. Storage of fats acts as an insulator for other connective tissues. For example, bones, ligaments, tendons and areola. So, this adipose tissue is like insulator for other connective tissue. Nervous tissue. Nervous tissues are highly specialized for being stimulated and then transmitting the messages rapidly from one place to another place within the body. The brain, spinal cord and nerves are all composed of nervous tissue. Now let's see the structure of nervous tissue first. You can see here the diagram of nerve cell, which helps in transfer of messages throughout the body, thus helping in the controlling of entire body. Neurons consist of cell body in which nucleus and cytoplasm together form cyton. From cytoplasm, a long thread-like branched structures arises. That structures are called dendrite. Each neuron has a single long part called axon. An individual nerve cell may be 1 meter long in length. Many nerve fibers bound together by connective tissue make a nerve. So student, this is the structure of nervous tissue. Then what is the functions of this nervous tissue? So student, nervous tissue is a very important tissue. How? Many times you all have experienced that whenever you touch a hot vessel, you instantly take your handbag. When you fall down, suddenly you immediately get a feeling of pain. In both the cases, you react instantly. Why does this happen? This is happen only because of nervous tissue. The cells of nervous tissue are highly specialized for being stimulated and then transmitting the messages rapidly from one place to another place within the body. And because of that, nervous tissue is the main tissue of the body. So this is all about nervous tissue.